traveling reporting for Katie Chat at Smithy TV in downtown Toronto. I'm here with Laurie Townsend, the filmmaker of The Real Path Hero. How does it feel to have the film in the Real World Film Festival?
It feels wonderful. It's a huge accomplishment for me. I was an emerging 20 several years ago. That was a really great opportunity to be mentored and to get some face-to-face time with some producers. At the time, The Real Path Hero, which was being titled The Arena, was a feature idea. It was a story I pitched for a feature film that was going to sort of chronicle the life of an up-and-coming hockey player, a story loosely based on my brother, who was a professional hockey player, young black kid growing up in Toronto, and the various trials and tribulations that elite athletes face. But, you know, for economical reasons and for just wanting to get the story off my chest and get it out there, I rewrote it and sort of repurposed it as a short film, and that ended up becoming The Real Path Hero and was shot and completed in 2013.
And you've also worked as an educator for many years. How has that experience influenced your filmmaking?
That's a really good question. You know, as a teacher, I teach middle school, so the age group, 12, 13, 14-year-old age group, that's sort of the demographic that I'm really comfortable with. And over the 16 years that I've been a public school educator, I've had the honor, I guess, of working with so many young people who've overcome insurmountable odds, and I sort of feel like the protagonists and the characters that I'm drawn to in the writing process tend to be composites of a lot of those kids that I've had the honor of working with in my classroom.
And the film deals with some serious topics such as sexual abuse with in terms of sports and athletics, and what's the importance of sort of creating a dialogue around those issues?
It's of utmost importance. I think anyone, I'm by no means an expert in the subject matter, but from the research that I've completed, I know that shame is equated with silence, and a lot of victims of childhood sexual abuse end up in this sort of vicious cycle of shame, blame, guilt, and silence. And anything that can be used as a starter, a place to start, to have a discussion, to talk about the issues that that surround childhood sexual abuse, and to I guess, you know, in another way, empower. I feel like the film can be used as a tool of empowerment for people, allies, and individuals who work with young people, because the more we talk about the signs, the more we talk about how to help a young victim disclose something like that, I think the more we can do to serve those people and those individuals and reduce the trauma. So yeah, the film is, it's on one hand, you know, it's been kind of, not that I'm not happy and I, you know, I'm celebrating the fact that the film is done, but the fact that it does deal with such a serious subject matter means that I have an eye on the sad statistics that are out there. Mm-hmm. And I always want to remind, you know, my viewers that it's not heavy in the sense that you're going to walk away feeling completely annihilated. It's definitely there are messages of hope and resilience in there, and that's what I want people to take away from the film.
And you also got a tremendous team of actors on board, including the lovely Kim Roberts. Tell me a little bit about the casting process.
Well, that was interesting. Kim Roberts ends up doing the voice of the mother, and it was a huge coup to get her, and she's a busy actress. The really cool thing about my lead, Stefan James, he was actually in Sad Sutherland's Home Again last year, premiered at TIFF. He's a former student of mine, and I had him for grade 7, grade 8 drama in Scarborough, and at the time he was really quite shy and quiet, real kind of brooding, serious kid, but knowing him now, I feel like he was just sort of taking it all in, and really when he went to high school, he left my school, he must have just, you know, hit his stride. And I've been following his career, and when I was writing the short script, the script for the short film, I had him in mind and made the effort to contact his older brother, who's sort of serving as his manager, and he was available and willing, and so that's how that happened, Stefan James. And you watch him on screen in some of the Degrassi work he's done, and in my film there were moments where we were in tears on set, and he's such a spectacular young actor.
And what was it like working with Peter Tufford Kennedy?
Yeah, you know what, Peter Tufford, I knew him as Tufford on set. He was a delight to work with, real professional, and talk about just bringing his best game to a really, really difficult role. It was really great working with him.
And where's the best place for us to find out more information on the film and where we can see it online?
Well, you can, for now, it's not available online. It's making its world premiere at the Real World Film Festival on April the 5th. At 6 p.m., the Famous Players Theater. And it will also get a second screening the following weekend on the 13th in the Markham extension of the festival. Mm-hmm. It's the first year they're doing that. So I'm really excited that it's going to get people, audiences will have two opportunities to see it in the next month. And then after that, we're working on sort of the educational sphere and getting it to in front of audiences of youth and youth workers and teachers. And But there will perhaps be an opportunity to put it online at the same time as that runs. So for now, you can just find out more information. We have a Facebook page, The Rail Path Hero, on Facebook, or a WordPress website, therailpathhero.wordpress.com.
Great. Well, thank you so much. Congratulations, and best of luck with the film.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm Katie Ullman reporting for Katie Chats in downtown Toronto. I'm Katie Ullman reporting for Katie Chats at Smithy TV in downtown Toronto. Be sure to check out the brand new Smithy TV app so you can watch all the great Smithy shows on your iPhone. Oh, those mind reels.